was just before the last great charge. Two soldiers held their reins. For a touch of the hand and a parting word that they never might meet again. One had dark blue eyes and curly hair, 19 but a month ago. Red on his cheek, down on his chin, he was only a boy, you know. The other was a tall, dark man whose faith in this world was him. He trusted only in those he loved. They were all his world to him. Together they rode up many a hill and marched for many a mile. But always had met the foe with a calm and happy smile. But now they gazed in each other's face with a silence awful gloom. The tall, dark man was the first to speak, saying, "Charlie, my hour has come. But we'll ride up this hill together, but you must ride back alone. And promise a little trouble to take for me when I am gone. I wear a photograph on my heart. I wear it in the fight. His soft blue eyes and curly hair and a form like the morning's light. A little we thought of the cares of the field when she promised to be my wife. Now write to her, Charlie, when I am gone. Bring back that winsome face and tell her tenderly where I'm laid. Where is my resting place? Tell her that I will wait for her and board the land heaven and earth until she comes. It won't be long, I mean." Tears filled the blue eyes of the boy, his voice grew low with pain. "I'll do your bidding, my comrade mine, if I march back again. But if I march back and you are shot, you must do the same for me. For I've a mother, must hear the news and write to her tenderly. One after the other of those she loved, she's buried her husband and son. And I was the last at my country's call, but she cheerily sent me on. She has stayed at home like a wasting saint, her fair face filled with woe. Her heart will be broken when I am gone. It won't be long, I know." Just then the bugle blew to charge for an instant hand clasp band. "Aye, aye," they cried, and away they rode, that brave, devoted band. Together they rode to the top of the hill, where the enemy shot and shell. For an instant death in their scattered ranks, but cheered them as they fell. At last they drew from those fatal heights which their valor could not gain. And those whom death and doom had spared rode slowly back again. But among the dead that were left in the field was a boy with the curly hair and a tall dark man that rode by.